Today I'm going to be talking about a simple way to add a thought or speech bubble to your movie in iMovie. Really easy, really simple, and it's free. You'll also be able to add things like emojis. So you have a video and you want to jazz it up a bit. So first, drag your movie that you want to edit into iMovie if it's not already there. Next, we need to create the graphic that we want to add into our movie. A great way of doing this is in Keynote. So open up a new slide, delete the stuff that you don't need, and we can start to add a shape. You can see Keynote helpfully already give you a load of different options. For my project here, I'm going to select Quote Bubble. It's really easy just by clicking and dragging and playing about with it to make it bigger, smaller, thinner, fatter, whatever you want. Don't worry about the exact size for now, because you can change that in iMovie. It's super simple. Just worry about that you've got the right shape and the right orientation. You can also change the colour of the speech bubble here. I'm going to stick with white. Now to add the text, whatever we want to put in there. I've decided I'm going to have one of the kittens going, help! Keynote will allow you to change the size of your font, the type of the font, and the colour of the font, so you can play around with those to your heart's content. The next thing you need to do is ensure the background is transparent so that you'll be able to see the rest of your movie beneath the speech bubble. It's going to look black in Keynote, so don't worry about that, but just make sure that you've got the background clicked no fill. Now you can export it as an image file and make sure that you click transparent background. Now drag the PNG that you've just created, your lovely speech bubble, and put it above your timeline, roughly where you'd like to have it in the movie. Now, as you can see, when you drag it in, it's huge, and we want to see cute kittens, and we also don't want a kitten talking out of his bottom. Or maybe you do, but that's not my kind of movie. So making sure that you have your speech bubble selected at the top of the timeline, click on Picture in Picture. You can then easily change the size and also the placement of your speech bubble. Also, by dragging it along your timeline, you can make it last any duration that you want it to. You can also add filters on your graphics. Now, I've actually decided I would like a thought bubble instead of a speech bubble, and Keynote doesn't give me a ready packaged option, but there's plenty of places on the net that you can get free thought bubbles. You can get them all sorts of shapes and sizes, all kinds of designs, and you really do not need to be paying for any of the graphics. The only thing that I would caution you of is make sure it's a royalty-free graphic, and if you're using it for commercial purposes, that you have a license for it. Don't be stealing images off the web. Now, I've also decided that I'm going to get an emoji from this site for my movie. Now go into Keynote to add text to your speech bubble. Just drag the image in. You'll notice though that you've got less flexibility than you do with Keynote's ready packaged shapes. You can't change the dimensions as easily. While I was hunting around the royalty-free images site, I found a purple thought bubble that I prefer to the white ones on. Remember to set your background to no fill, and also when you export your image, export it as an image with a transparent background. So that's what my PNG looks like, and I'm going to drag it into iMovie now. Just like before, if we set it as picture in picture, we can change the size and placement of our bubble and basically put it anywhere we want in the frame. Now I've decided I'd also like to add an emoji into my movie, and so I just drag that into the timeline. To change your emoji size, just set it to picture in picture. But for some reason, it's decided in this case to kind of crop it, so you just need to set it to fit and it will be fine. Now here's a preview of how my movie looks with the thought bubble and the emoji added. Now looking at that, my eye tells me I think I can improve on that even more. So the cool thing is I can just click on my graphics and put a filter to them there. And I've decided I'd like to make it a little yellow. So there you go. I think that suits the colouring of the cats much better. If I thought about that at the time, I could have done that in Keynote. But I can't bother to go back to Keynote and simple click on the filter. You play about with it and discover things that you didn't even see at the time. So that's it for now. Thank you for joining me. I'll be posting more videos soon about what things you can do in iMovie, so keep an eye out.